Hi, this is Gabe Romero and Martin Flewell from Mann Packing. We're here today to give you July's field report. Martin, the weather in June, it's been pretty erratic.
Yeah, we didn't see our typical June gloom that we're used to here in the Salinas Valley. We had some hard-hitting rains, we had some real warm temperatures, so kind of that nice mellow fog that we typically see kind of burning off towards the afternoon was replaced with some pretty extreme stuff.
So with the heat, obviously seed varieties play into play, right? Tell me a little bit about that.
Yeah, so we're targeting stuff that's going to be surviving that kind of late night, early morning cloud cover, our kind of June gloom, cooler temps that we normally see this time of year. With the spike in heat, some things like broccoli, cauliflower just stop growing when that happens. Other things like lettuce, when it's really warm, the plant's taking up a lot of water and growing really quickly as well. And so those two things combined, it can't take up enough calcium onto those inner smaller leaves. And so you'll end up with internal tip burn. Other things that it does when it gets really hot, it starts getting hot down in South County and pulling that cold air from over the Monterey Bay and creates a huge amount of wind, which has caused a lot of damage to the outer leaves on things like romaine and greenleaf, which is what you refer to as fringe burn. A little bit of damage like right around the very tips of the lettuce.
With the heat, obviously that affected a little bit of labor. Does the hours change or how does it work?
Yeah, so you don't have to change your time for harvesting, but we do. So we're starting earlier. So crews, it might've been starting at 4 or 6 a.m. or typically starting at 2 a.m. So what we're trying to do is get that stuff harvested both for the plant's health and for the people's health while it's not too hot during the day. And making sure that you've got a good, healthy plant that's ready for whatever gets thrown at it so it's got the best chance of survival is really what we're focused on going forward. Hopefully we don't get too many curveballs thrown at us and we can have a nice steady month of July.
Certainly. And as you know, supplies have been pretty steady on broccoli and cauliflower moving forward. As the local produce deals start, from Canada to the Northwest to even the Southeast, we'll look for those to take as far as the demand is concerned. So the first couple of weeks of July could be a little shaky when it comes to markets as well as supplies, and hopefully we'll level off and get better as the month goes. So from Martin Flewell and Gabe Romero here for the July Field Report, hope you have a safe and happy 4th of July, and we'll see you next time.